As a person who went to UCLA to study design media arts, I can personally tell you that you do not need a... What's up, everybody? It's your boy, Nate. So I wanted to take this time to answer some of you guys' most asked questions regarding pursuing animation, motion graphics. This question from Matt Green, who is a patron on our Patreon. I think it echoes a question that a lot of you have been asking, especially those of you who are in college or thinking about going to college and studying motion graphics and animation. Matt Green asks, what are my thoughts on going to school for animation and media art? And what are my thoughts for making the most out of it? Well, as a person who went to UCLA to study design media arts, I can personally tell you that you do not need a fancy university degree in order to start learning motion graphics, VFX, animation, or even video in general. About going to school for animation media arts, there's a lot of good, a little bit of bad that I can say about it. A lot of the things that I ended up using from studying design media arts for 4 years weren't things that were super apparent to me at first. So it wasn't like I was there talking about cameras and camera gear and aspect ratios and how to render out a video. Instead, it was more of the conceptual things like color composition, form, what else? Yeah, a lot of the basic principles of art in general, which honestly I had no idea about before going into it. So as a high schooler, really most of what I did was music videos and interviews and stuff like that. Really just treating video in a super technical way, I'd probably say, with a little bit of, you know, finessing around here and there. But it wasn't until really going to school for it that I was able to hone into, I guess, some of the reasons for the decisions I was making in videos. Yeah, just having like a more fuller knowledge of it. So another important thing about going to college for it is the network. You will probably not have as much close access to people who are driven around similar ideologies as you are, as you will have in college. And even then, you're going to find a lot of people who are doing just like completely off things that you just have no idea about. But being around that many people, that many collaborative thinkers, and that many people pursuing stuff, it's just a really great energy. Those are like some of the intangible aspects of going to college for it, or really going to school to study anything. However, there has not been a specific time that I have gotten a job only because of my UCLA degree. In fact, most of the freelance work that I got was from people looking at my work online through things like Instagram. Surprisingly, when I think back to it, YouTube was another thing. So I had a few videos actually that people would reach out after seeing them on YouTube and would ask for stuff like that. What else? Oh shoot, and even just a lot of people that I would interact with would know that I did videos. So a lot of still person-to-person engagements. It wasn't ever like I pulled out a diploma like, hey, I'm certified to do this. One of the cool things about this field, and I guess one of the hard things about it too, is that essentially the work speaks for itself. So if the work looks dope, you're gonna attract people are gonna ask for stuff. If it doesn't look dope, just keep trying, keep making stuff, and honestly, you only get better by making more stuff. Now again, though, I say this not to discourage those of you who aren't going to school for this and who are maybe even picking this up later on. So if you're sitting at home watching this and you're thinking you just have no idea where to start, how much money this is gonna cost, or how much time you even have to put into learning something like this, well, I can tell you that I started learning it with $0. I mean, technically, I still had stuff. Like, if you're watching this, you probably are watching it on a computer or a cell phone. And the very first videos that I ever did were actually on a super, super webcam on a laptop that wasn't even mine. It was my mom's one. So there's ways to get started. Now, if you're wondering where to start learning, there are so many different resources. So I actually started first from watching YouTube videos. I think it's actually pretty fitting why I teach video and media on YouTube now, because pretty much as a 12-year-old, when YouTube was first kind of like popping off and people were actually like putting super high value skills online for free, YouTube was my main resource. I would sit and watch videos for like hours and hours a day and then just try making something at night. I probably slept like 4 hours for like 3 months. And out of that, I just ended up knowing a lot about After Effects. So I can guarantee if you guys are just even at home and you can't afford to go to college for something like this, or maybe you don't even have the time to like block off to do that, who's just pretty much on that college lane. I'm just gonna make it on my own. The cool thing about YouTube is that you can really watch it on your own time. So you can make something work out for your own schedule and pretty much do things at your own pace, control it, go forwards, backwards, you know, rewatch things, which fit my type of learning style. But I definitely understand for some of you guys who maybe need a little bit more direction or just even want the entire community experience, because you know, learning online by yourself can be pretty isolating. Another thing that I've been seeing pop up a lot more frequently in the past few years are things like Motion Design School, Lynda.com. Oh shoot, Skillshare as well. So those are some pretty huge platforms for learning a lot of high value skills. I personally dislike Lynda though, because I always found the content on there to be super, super boring. It was like almost impossible for me to follow along. So I would actually watch Video Copilot to learn After Effects. He just made things a lot more fun and entertaining and really was showing skills that I could apply right away. And also I watched things like Mount MoGraph on YouTube, Freddie Wong, there's a lot of people on YouTube that are just giving out a lot of cool stuff for free as well. So if you also don't have enough money to spend on something like Skillshare or lynda.com or any of those subscription stuff, go ahead and look up stuff on YouTube. Also right now, thanks to Adobe for being super responsive about the whole quarantine. And so it looks like they're giving students a free 2 months of Adobe, which is pretty sweet. Now just make sure you guys watch out, because Adobe in the past has tried to fuck me over and charge me for shit that I didn't do. So yeah, make sure you also cancel those subscriptions if you guys don't like the software. But hey, I actually love Adobe software. It's really dope. That's why I keep using it over and over again. But just know they have like done some shady charging stuff in the past. Now, one of the huge barriers to entry is of course the software and the cost of the software. Back in the day, like 10 years ago, I'm pretty sure After Effects costs, I think $300-$400 for a license. But nowadays you're able to get all the programs for about, I think it's like $30 or $40, or even just one license of the program for about $20, which is super great and affordable. I think honestly breaks down the barrier for entry. Another huge thing is what hardware are you gonna use? You don't have to worry about really like a super decked out computer that just is like insane. It will help when it comes to handling difficult tasks, but when you're just starting out, I think the most important thing to do is just get creating. But the cool part about video is that there's a lot of things that you just have to know. There's a lot of things that you can also kind of experiment with, and those experimentations mixed with the technicalities ultimately develop a really cool style that's unique. And then sometimes even people who are just doing all kinds of off strange stuff that no one has ever thought of before, those things become very unique. Make the most out of it. Yeah, so anyways, this turned out to be a much longer answer to your question. Hopefully other people will be able to find some value in it. I know that as an aspiring animator and motion graphics artist and VFX artist back in the day, I really wish that someone just kind of broke down all the different avenues or routes or things that I could do going into it. So hopefully you are able to have some takeaways from this that will propel your future career in the right direction. And if you haven't already, make sure that you hit that subscribe button and turn on the notification bell so you don't miss out on any of the super dope videos that we have planned. We're gonna be talking about all kinds of things, from motion tracking to the best video editors to just how to even get started in the wonderful world of motion graphics and VFX and art, digital media. And yeah, it just goes on. Just subscribe if you haven't already. It's super dope. Now, if you guys have any other questions, I'm probably gonna be doing like a whole batch answering of questions. We tried to do a 50K Q&A once we hit 50K subscribers, but then I got sick and then coronavirus happened. Yeah, just a whole lot of stuff kind of got shifted around, so we didn't get to do that. Next thing that we knew, we were at 64,000 subscribers. So who knows, maybe I'll plan in advance for 100K subs. We're hoping to hit that pretty soon. So make sure you guys send in your questions that we can put it onto the list. And then hopefully I have that video out for you guys. As always, I hope you guys enjoyed this, and I hope to catch you in the next one. Peace.